Drive Time with Vernon Howe. Drive Time with Vernon Howe. Drive Time with Vernon Howe. In the car, computer, car. Hey, that was the theme song. I forgot to mention all this time that this is actually the second series of a show. There was about, I don't know, I think I did 30 episodes of Drive Time and stopped doing it, and I didn't pick it up with the same number, which, you know, another thing about, would have made some sense a little bit. I did want to correspond and hook up with a new podcast, of which should be new episodes soon. Three more episodes are basically done. It should be out soon. And I think I got that down. Everything's coming together, kind of, this week. I felt overwhelmed, but I was doing some work, and it was not, and it didn't feel like it was adding up as fast as I'd like, but that happens. But it's getting there. And I got some work done this morning, and, you know, it's fine. I didn't do a AM version of the drive time today, so this is 11A, but it's 12:57 PM Eastern Standard Time on this Friday, 15th day of March, 2013. Still chilly out, but not too bad. It could be warmer, but I don't think it's supposed to rain, so that's good. I should check on that. I think tomorrow there might be some chance of rain, or one day of the weekend was supposed to maybe be crappy, cold and rainy, but I don't think today. I think it should be clear today, which is good. Looking forward to the weekend. I'm going to push myself hard tonight, doing some art, and then crash out, I hope, for like 15 hours. I wish. I don't know what the prolonged effect of only getting like 6 hours of sleep is during it. And I think I'm being like, I've been waking the last 2 days. I think I figured out what it was. I wasn't setting my phone to silence. So I think the tone of my email was kind of waking. I was getting email like early in the morning. It was waking me up because I was very tired. But I was like, "Why am I awake? What in my body is telling me to get out of bed?" Because I've been falling asleep pretty easily, but I have this thing that, like, jolts me out of bed like 10 minutes before my alarm goes off. It's very odd. Now usually that's not the case with me, especially because it's pretty early. It's like 6:50. I'm getting up. I don't know what that's all about. That's something to look into. Hopefully it doesn't happen on the weekend. My plan is with my dogs and I is to walk him like at 1 o'clock in the morning for like 2 miles. So he sleeps and just doesn't want to fuck with his cycles. Big time. I'm coming for you. Fucking with my dogs. I'm gleefully fucking with my dog's sleep cycle. So I can sleep in. So 1 o'clock tonight, we are gonna voyage downtown. We're gonna go downtown. Yeah, I said it. Me and my dog. See if there's any drunk people to amuse me. Take a break from whatever I'm doing. That's the idea. It should be fun, I think. Should be kinda cool. But yeah. Like I said, my wife is in California. I've been here talking to myself. I haven't spoken to another person. That's why, you know, I spoke to my dad this morning. That's why I didn't do a morning version of this show, because I was on the phone with my dad. I actually got to call, trying to make plans for Easter again. It's a mess. Can't find any hotels or Airbnb. Airbnb weirds me out anyway. This one guy, he had two bathroom place, and we're looking for 6 people to stay and a small kid, and I emailed the guy. I was like, "Well, yeah, you know, there's 2 full baths, 2 bedrooms, and, you know, living room. We have an air mattress. We have 6 people in the small." And he's like, "No, I really would rather only 4." Like, okay, but don't you just want to get paid? Like, what? He's like, "I've had problems with big groups," is what he said. I didn't go back. I don't know. I'm sure he's gonna have no problem. He was had a fair price. I was almost like, we'll pay a little more, you know, for what you want. I don't know how that works. You know, I guess, it's his apartment. He doesn't want it to get, you know, fucking trashed. I understand that. And but you're going to trust four people over six people. Four people, if you ran into four people, let's say you ran into four 21-year-olds on spring break, not that they would go, not that spring break is an Easter weekend in a city like that, but my point is, four adults who are capable adults, who are, 21-year-olds, who are raging alcoholics, could trash your place, but, six adults visiting family, what's the difference? But yeah, this guy's head, in selling and renting his place out in the Airbnb, that was it. Like, once you make the choice to, like, basically trust strangers into your house, you think two more people are just going to make a difference? Like, what? And you're not there, so how is it? The way he phrased it was very odd. I was like, would you come by and hang out with people? Very odd. The whole Airbnb. I don't think I've ever booked one myself, but I've been with people who booked in and stayed at an Airbnb place, or at least I've gone over and hung out with people who were at Airbnb or doing an Airbnb thing. Maybe at a hotel somewhere, so something like that. I don't know. It gives me a little, creeped out thinking about it, I don't know why. It bugs me out a little bit. I guess that's probably it's a personal thing that it's wrong with me that I'm bugged. I'm not saying it isn't. Like, there's a trust thing going on between humans there that should be, that I should at least respect. And I do, I guess I do, but it's so fucking arbitrary and weird. Like, I don't know who I am anymore.